Talk to you a little bit about some med ball training, some ballistic training, and everybody who's familiar with boxing gym knows about medicine balls, and they're cool. You know, they're an extremely versatile piece of equipment, and one of the things that you can do is ballistic training, meaning you're throwing an object at something, and what this does for the athlete, what this does for the boxer is this teaches us how to be faster. This improves our neural connection to our muscles. This improves our rate of fire of our muscle fibers. So one of the cool drills that I have my fighters here do is they'll be in their boxing stance.
It's a 9-pound ball.
This is a 9-pound med ball. Uh-huh. This is the lightest one that we have in the gym. And it's a little bit squishy, so it's easy to grip. Anyways, I'll have my fighter get into their boxing stance, a little bit of a chatter, and then using the technique of throwing a jab, they will toss out this ball to somebody catching the ball. The person catching the ball will toss it right back to them in their jabbing hand. But we just repeat the process, just like this. So I'm teaching my body how to use force production, teaching my neural systems how to call upon my muscles to do the particular task. And I'm also improving the strength of my jab going through this movement.
Are you catching the ball with both hands or one hand?
I'm only catching the ball in the particular hand that I'm working for this drill in particular. But Ellie, you can design this drill any way you feel fit depending on what your goals are.
Let me see it one more time. So you're working like on a jab, like you're throwing a jab, right?
So I'm in my boxing stance. I'm going to be practicing my jab. I'm going to step in. I'm going to rotate my arm. And then I'm going to turn my hand over. And that force is what's going to propel the ball. I'm going to keep it out here, and when it comes back, I just suck it back in, just the reverse motion to work a little bit of eccentric contraction. Coming out, coming back in, stepping in, stepping back, think, boom. I can do it just like it's a right hand and turn my hip over and throw it that way. I can even stand sideways with my opponent and throw it like it's a hook. It's just a fun way to get these principles in and to mix up training.
Would it help my punching power if I do this? Will I hit then like Brandon Rios?
You may not hit like Brandon Rios, but yes, this would improve your punching power, setback.
Very cool. So I'm definitely going to start using that. I could buy it at any store. Can I do it against the wall if I don't have someone to catch it for me?
If you have a ball that bounced, you can do that. That ball's not going to be capable of that.
You think I could break a window?
Well, you could definitely break a window or get somebody pretty pissed at you, Ellie, trying to improve your punching power. But I suggest you do it. Find a wall that won't break. Or better yet, go find a friend and do it with him.
Or come here to Outlaws Boxing Club.
Come here to Outlaws Boxing. We'll do it with you until you're blue in the face.
There you have it. So another boxing technique right here. If you're starting boxing, it's a great place to learn. The Outlaws Boxing Club in Tarzana for EastNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Stackback reporting. Yeah.